I'm talking about Hakeem Jeffries. He goes off on Clarence Thomas, Ginni Thomas. He let him have it. Here's a video.
And if Justice Thomas really wants to deal with bullying in America, or this problem of people supposedly unwilling to accept outcomes that they don't like, I've got some advice for Justice Thomas. Start in your own home. Have a conversation with Ginni Thomas. She refused to accept the legitimacy of the 2020 presidential election. Why? Because she didn't like the outcome. And so instead, she tried to steal the election, overthrow the United States government, and install a tyrant. That's bullying. That's being unwilling to accept an outcome because you don't like the results, because the former twice impeached so-called president of the United States of America lost legitimately to Joe Biden. How did she respond? Instead, she said the Bidens should face a military tribunal in Guantanamo Bay on trumped up charges of sedition. You've got to be kidding me. And lastly, let me ask this question of Brother Thomas. Why are you such a hater? Hate on civil rights, hate on women's rights, hate on reproductive rights, hate on voting rights, hate on marital rights, hate on equal protection under the law, hate on liberty and justice for all, hate on free and fair elections. Why are you such a hater? And you think you can get away with it, escape public scrutiny? Because you think that shamelessness is your superpower?
Mr. Chairman, a point
of order. Well, here's a news flash straight from the House Judiciary Committee.
Point of order.
Truth pressed to the ground will rise again, and truth will be your kryptonite.
Damn your point of order. Let that brother speak. Now, I need to provide some context here, because this is rare. We do not have on record a United States congressperson during an official proceeding calling out the spouse of a Supreme Court justice. It needed to be done. Ginni damn Thomas is out of control. Clarence Thomas been out of control. We already know that. We have more information about his wife, Ginni Thomas, who I believe has influenced him in major judicial decisions based on her public advocacy and his direct vote as a justice. And many of those votes were in contrast, were contrary to the votes of other conservatives on the bench, but they aligned with his wife. She tried to get the chief of staff of Donald Trump to basically overthrow democracy, to shred the US Constitution, told him it was God telling him to do so. I guarantee you this. If God wanted Trump to be president, your damn text messages would not change it. Let's get into it. First of all, let me make sure we do this proper. Let's put up our dear brother Hakeem Jeffries, American politician and attorney. He served, who served as the US representative for New York's 8th congressional district since 2013. He's a member of the Democratic Party, represents a district that covers parts of Eastern Brooklyn, Southwestern Queens in New York City. So let's now go to the content of what the good congressman is saying here. Supreme Court Justice Clarence Thomas doesn't want people bullying government institutions. He went on record and said this. The Supreme Court Justice criticized people, and I quote, becoming addicted to wanting particular outcomes, not living with the outcomes we don't like. Well, my friend, you're lecturing people in this country. You're lecturing us about not accepting outcomes. When your wife at your home, whom you say sleeps next to you, has engaged in criminal conduct to overthrow the results of a presidential election. There's more. There are emails. The emails show, we're talking about new emails. They show that Thomas's efforts, we're talking about Ginni, her efforts to overturn the election were more extensive than previously known. Two people said. The three declined to provide details and spoke on the condition of anonymity to discuss sensitive matters. The January 6th committee, they got access to this stuff. The committee's members and staffers are now discussing whether to spend time during their public hearings exploring Ginni Thomas's role in the attempt to overturn the outcome of the 2020 election. Why are you discussing it? The evidence is there. She was involved. We got text messages with her and many other people, including the chief of staff, other state lawmakers, and lawmakers in DC. We got it. It's right there. Other publications have already published it. You mean to tell me there has to be a conversation in the committee if she needs to be under investigation? She's married to a freaking United States Supreme Court justice. She needs to be under investigation, of course. And this is why these institutions piss me off sometimes, especially the left-leaning ones. It is no question that we as a country deserve to know the extent of her criminal involvement. She admitted 1 year later that she actually attended the rally that led to the terrorist attack, which means she went there secretly. If this was all about upstanding democratic principles, who would go there in secret except for Ginni Thomas? So I agree with the congressman. Clarence, your wife is out of control. So are you. All right, Yasmin, thoughts?
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how the January 6th committee deals with Ginni Thomas in the coming hearings. I know there's one going on right now, and I will catch up with that afterwards. But yeah, we've seen reports that her involvement is a lot more than what we previously thought it was. And you know, I look at a lot of different conflicts that happen currently and also throughout history, and you always see, you know, really delusional people with really strong convictions who are acting based on these convictions and hurting people, like hundreds, thousands, nations and societies worth of people, just because they believe in something that, you know, nobody else really understands. You know, like for example, Putin is invading Ukraine right now because he really believes that it's his right to do so. He believes that Ukraine is a part of Russia and that it's his job, it's his duty here to reunite all that. And so many people are suffering because of that. So being convicted isn't always such a good thing. You know, being humble is a good thing. Taking a step back and checking your own ego can be a good thing. And just, you know, understanding that maybe you don't understand everything and you don't have all the answers is a good thing, and more people need to do that. In this case, though, Ginni Thomas needs to be held accountable for what she's done. And we also need to be looking into Clarence Thomas and rethinking maybe his seat on the Supreme Court.
Yeah. And here's the thing. I reported yesterday on experts and friends, former friends of Ginni Thomas. Some of them were connected back during her anti-cult days. And they're saying, listen, her behavior seems like she's back in a cult again. Instead of it being LifeSpring, it's QAnon. The language that we see, it seems as if she's back in the cult.